The disease was considered so revolting that the leper wasn't permitted to come within 150 feet of anyone when the wind was blowing. Lepers lived in a community with other lepers until they either got better or died. All they could do was stand by the street and beg. Then one day, something happened that changed their lives. The lepers are sitting on the street.
Oh no! I've been touched by an unclean leper! I was on my way to worship God, and now I'm unclean. Curse on you, you filthy man.
Upset by this, she turns and walks back and is met by other people.
What happened? Why are you so upset?
The wretched leper touched me, and now I'm unclean. These wretched people will make us and our children sick. God has punished them for their sins. Why should we suffer because of them?
That is very true. The other day, one of the lepers almost fell on my feet. He was begging for food. I can't even imagine him touching me. All those dirty, stinking lepers.
They have been abandoned by their own family, and now they are cursed for us when we walk down the streets.
They should not be allowed to live with us clean people. Let us drive them out of our town.
Yes, let us drive them out!
The crowd throws stones at the lepers and shouts at them to leave their city. The poor lepers run for their lives. The people drive the lepers out of the town. Now they sit outside the city gate, scratching and cursing their fate, and hoping that someone would be merciful enough to throw them some leftovers. That's when one day they hear people talking about Jesus coming that way.
Did you hear the good news?
What good news?
I didn't hear anything.
Me either. Jesus is coming to town.
I heard he has healed many lepers like us. He has made the blind see and the crippled walk. They say he's the Messiah.
Really? I can't wait to see him. He is the one who can heal us.
Oh, but we'll never be able to get close enough.
Yeah, you're right.
We can't get near the crowd of people.
No, but we can shout and draw his attention. This is our only chance. We must draw his attention.
Oh, look! There's Jesus!
I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
Jesus, have mercy on us!
You are right, but why is he walking towards the dirty lepers?
Maybe Jesus doesn't know their lepers. Let's warn him.
Jesus, don't go to them! They are unclean! They are lepers!
Jesus turns and looks towards the crowd. And looks toward the lepers and smiles. Jesus walks toward the lepers with much love and compassion.
Jesus, Master, have pity on us!
Jesus is looking at us.
I know.
He's looking right at us.
Do not be afraid. God loves you. Go to the temple and show yourselves to the priest.
What did Jesus say?
He said we should show ourselves to the priests.
But we are not allowed to go near him. We are unclean. I still have all my sores.
Yeah, me too. This doesn't make any sense.
What are we supposed to do?
I don't know.
I think we need to do what Jesus said.
He said, go to the temple and show yourselves to the priest. So let's go.
Wait a minute.
What is it?
My sores are gone.
Mine too.
Mine are gone and so are yours.
You're right. Wow.
I can't believe it. I can see.
This is unbelievable. I don't need this crutch anymore.
My skin is clean and healthy.
I don't limp anymore.
Me either.
It's true. Jesus has healed us.
We are healed!
We
can go back to our families. Yay!
Before we go to our families, we need to do what Jesus said. Let us go to the priest.
What did Jesus tell them? Go see the priest? The priest is not going to allow them anywhere near.
Yeah, they're unclean and they'll come right back.
I see one leper coming back.
You're right! I see one too!
Nine of the lepers walk off celebrating, but one leper goes back to Jesus.
Jesus!
Jesus stops and turns around. The crowd stops as well. All look at the leper, who is now completely healed.
That man used to be a leper!
He's healed!
Be quiet! What is he saying? Jesus! Thank you for healing me.
We're not all the 10 cleansed. Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give praise to God except for this foreigner? Rise and go. Your faith has made you well.
The key lesson to be learned from this Bible story is that sin defiles us in the sight of God. But through Christ, we can be healed of the leprosy of sin that separates us from God. Sin is not just sexual immorality, but every act of disobedience. Rebellion, disbelief is sin. Sin bans us from the presence of God because with our sins we cannot withstand the glory of God, who is all pure and holy. But in sincere humility, when we plead for cleansing and forgiveness, He will not turn us away. At the same time, let us not forget His compassion, which we take for granted every single day. May His loving mercy and compassion be felt by one and all. God bless.
Great job, guys. Special thanks to Joseph Funkel and Julie Tichy for working on this. And-